Welcome, dear brothers and sisters in our Lord Jesus Christ and all who are assisting this sermon. Today I would like to speak about tribulation, the great tribulation. Many are asking, Wilfred, you are talking about many times in your sermons about the great tribulation. What is it? Well, to be in details, you need to go to my sermons about Revelation. There I explain in details. Many people don't wish to know about the great tribulation. They say it is terror, it is horror. But be honest, people, many films nowadays, they are terror, they are violence. We have Star Trek, we have Star Wars, we have zombies. So why not speak about Revelation? Yes, but God is love. You can't say and speak about the terror of God, the wrath of God. But let us please be honest, it is going to happen. We are living in the final times. We are seeing all those earthquakes, all those wars which are going on. We are living clearly in the final time. How can we know it? Well, we have Revelation, but not only Revelation. Already Daniel is speaking about a little bit about the tribulations. Joel, Ezekiel, but in details we get it in the book of Revelation. Wilfred, the book Revelation, that last book of the Bible, it is a revelation of God. Don't be mistaken about that. Revelation 1, the revelation of Jesus Christ, which God gave him to show to his servants. We are his servants. What soon must take place. And he made known. It is made known to us. Made it known by sending his angel to his servant, the apostle John, who was in prison at the island Patmos, who bore witness to the word of God and to the testimony of Jesus Christ. Blessed is he who reads aloud the words of the prophecy, and blessed are those who hear it and keep it in their minds. It is given to us as a warning. Not all, because in Daniel 12 it is stated in verse 9, the angel said, go your way, Daniel, for the words are shut up and sealed until the time of the end. There is still a book which is hidden with much more information. And it is also stated in Revelation 10, verse 4. There are still things which are hidden, which will be revealed, made public in the final time. Daniel 12, verse 7 says, the second part of the great tribulation takes a time, two times, and half a time. A time, 1 year, times, 2 years, and half a time, 3.5 years. And I will speak in this sermon about this last part of the Great Tribulation, which takes 2 times 3.5 years. The first 3.5 years with the 2 witnesses and the 144,000 out of the 12 tribes of Israel, they will proclaim the kingdom of God. The Great Tribulation, why do we call it the tribulation? Because Jesus, before he went to the cross, he says in Matthew 24, verse 9, they, your Christians, you believers, those Christians who stayed behind, they deliver you up to tribulation and put you to death. And one will betray one another, and you will be hated by the world. And this gospel, verse 14, this gospel of the kingdom will be preached throughout the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end will come. Not the gospel, not the salvation through the blood of Jesus Christ, no, the gospel of the kingdom as Jesus Christ preached when he was on earth. The Great Tribulation, how much time will take it? It will take 1260 days, and taking the Jewish calendar, 30 days in a month, it comes to 3.5 years, 42 months. Period of relative peace, when the 2 witnesses and the people out of the 12 tribes are proclaiming the kingdom. Daniel 12 says, verse 4, the knowledge will increase. Yes, people, you could laugh in the past about the chip in the hand, on the forehead, but the ship exists nowadays. Israel returned to their promised land. Many things which we laughed about in the past, we have the knowledge, we can explain it. We have the Star Wars, the Star Trek, with all those horror films, with all those monsters, strange animals, strange people. So we know already that Revelation is true. We can't laugh about it and past and put aside. Who will pass through that great tribulation? Well, there are various opinions about that. My personal opinion is that the people who serve Jesus Christ, accepted Jesus Christ as Savior and Lord, the wise virgins out of Matthew 24, they will be taken before the Great Tribulation by Jesus Christ. And those foolish virgins, they will stay behind, who like to live their own life, who don't accept Jesus Christ as Lord. They are the foolish virgins. They stay behind at the rapture of the church, and they will pass to the Great Tribulation. There are others who say, no, the complete church. They will pass through the first 3.5 years of the Great Tribulation. While others say, no, the church will pass through those 7 years of Great Tribulation. And when Jesus is coming back, and all people on earth will see him, the church will be taken, and we will return with Jesus to the earth. Go and return. Isn't that foolish? Sorry to say about that. So, be prepared. What is your choice? Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord? Are you serving him here now on earth? Or are you willing and taking the chance to stay behind and pass through the tribulation? Which shall explain what will happen in that period. You can escape the Great Tribulation by accepting Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord, serving him, and be a wise version, as I explained in my sermon of Matthew 25. Let us go to Revelation. You may say that it's terror, but let us please be realistic. It is Jesus who told that he informs his church, inform mankind. So, what will happen in the Great Tribulation? As I said, I will not explain the first 3.5 years. I will tell you about the tribulation, especially in those last 3.5 years. Then Satan, he has seated himself in the temple. And Daniel 12 verse 11 says, 1290 days, Satan will be offering to himself in the temple. Do you resist him, not to adore him? And do you continue to resist him 45 days more? That will be hard. The time is given. Exactly in Daniel. We go now to Revelation 8. The wrath of God upon men who refuse to adore his creator. His creator, who created that universe, tree, fishes, birds, and mankind. Be honest, your brain. No computer can compute with your brain. No supercomputer. No artificial intelligence. Your mind is working, can solve problems. Those supercomputer, it is only zero and ones. It must be broken. It can't think for itself. And God created your brains. That intelligence. You are refusing to give God the honor. So yes, God has given you the opportunity by Jesus Christ to be saved. And if you are steadfast or refusing, you will experience the fruits of God. Recognize that He has all the power, not Satan. You are still given the opportunity to convert. So let us see what is going to happen upon the fruits of God. First, there are the seven trumpets. Revelation 8. And the first angel blew his trumpet, and there was hell and fire falling on earth. And the third of the earth was burnt up, the third of the trees. The grass was burnt up. Can you imagine that? Hailstones, fire, fruit trees destroyed, grass for the cows, no milk. The second angel blew his trumpet. And something like a great mountain burning like a fire, a comet, reached the sea. The sea, a third of the sea became blood, and a third of the living creatures, dolphins, fishes, they were killed, as well as a third of the ships were destroyed. A terrible smell. No water to drink. No fishes more to eat. A terrible time. The third angel blew his trumpet, and a great star fell from heaven. A satellite, a comet, we don't know. In the vision of the apostle, it was a great star coming from earth, from heaven, blazing like a torch, and it fell on the third of the rivers and on the fountains of water. The name of the star is Wormwood. And many people died because the water was bitter. Star fell in the rivers and the fountains. All the fishes died. No drinking water. No fishes to eat. Verse 12 of Revelation 8. The fourth angel blew his trumpet, and the third of the sun, and the third of the moon, and the third of the stars, they were struck, and they didn't shine anymore, and the third of the day was kept from shining, as well as the night. We have had the eclipse in the United States. Darkness. I walked in the mountains in Minas Gerais in Brazil. Darkness. You can't see anything without a lamp. It is darkness. You can't see where you are walking. You need a lamp. It is that dark. And that is what is going to happen. Chapter 9. And the fifth angel blew his trumpet, and the star fell from heaven to earth, and from the pit came out locusts with a sting, with the power of scorpions, and they stinked the men who had the seal on their hands or on their foreheads. And they were tortured for 5 months. They cried it out. They shouted that they wished to die, but they were unable to suicide, to kill themselves. A terrible torture. Continue in verse 13. Then the sixth angel blew his trumpet, and there came out horses in my vision with fire, smoke, and silver out of the mouths, and by their plagues a third of mankind was killed by this fire, smoke, and silver. Despite that, mankind didn't repent of their works. They continued to worship demons, idols of gold and silver and bronze and stone and wood, which can't either hear or walk, and they didn't repent, this mankind, of their murders, their thefts, their immorality, and their sorceries. Wilfred, horses with fire. Well, we know the stories, the kids' stories of dragons. We see many films, animations, films like dinosaurs of dragons issuing fire out of the mouth and silver. So we don't need to wonder about these animals. We are looking for the future. And despite all the suffering, they continue to adore demons, Satan, idols made by hand. So let us continue with the great tribulation in Revelation 16. Revelation 16 says, then started the angels that pour out the seven bowls of the wrath of God upon earth. The first angel poured out his bowl with full and evil scores entering upon men. Full and evil scores. You can think about Chernobyl, where as a result of the radiation, people had awful bowls. Children were born misformed. It was terrible, the results. So we had a great warning by God, and we know what might happen. The second angel poured out his bowl into the sea, and it became like the blood of a dead man. Every living thing died that was in the sea. Formerly it was one third, now all oceans and seas, they turn in blood. All fishes die, all living creatures in the sea. So a great reduction of drinking water, of fishes, food to eat. And it continues. The third angel poured out his bowl into the rivers and the fountains of water. It turned into blood. No more at all drinking water. No more fishes from the rivers to eat. A terrible and hard time. And to increase it, mice in verse 8 of chapter 16, the fourth angel poured out his bowl on the sun, and it was allowed to scorch men with fire. No drinking water, not able to take a shower, not going to the swimming pool because it turned into blood. And now the sun, it is scorching men. We don't need to be surprised. We know if the ozone layer is taken away, we have already the heat of the sun. We need to protect it with form 60, 80 against. So, yes, we know that this radiation is fairly possible. Verse 12, the sixth angel poured out his bowl on the great river Euphrates, and his water was dried up to prepare the way for the kings from the east. Already we are seeing that the Euphrates is drying up and forming an omega. Jesus is the omega, is the end. He has all the power. And the nations from the east, they have the freeway to Israel. All those nations, they will go up to Israel to the battle of Armageddon. I don't know if you have been in Israel. It is an enormous city. There will take place the battle of Armageddon. There will be the battle. And Jesus Christ, with the taken up, elevated church, he will return to that valley, to Jerusalem, Armageddon, and there will be the great battle of all those nations, Satan, demons, and they will be destroyed by fire, smoke, and sulfur, by a great earthquake. They will be thrown into the lake of fire forever. Except for Satan, he will be chained in the pits for 1,000 years. And after that, he will be released a little time for all those who haven't given their heart in the millennium, the 1,000 years of kingdom of Jesus Christ. They will go up again with Satan. And Satan and his followers, they will be thrown definitely forever, eternally, in the lake of fire. That's the great tribulation. A terrible time in which you are given the opportunity to convert yourself, to still accept Jesus as King. It is up to you to take that decision. I hope you understand the message of God the Father to accept Jesus Christ as your Savior and now. The rapture of the church, it cannot occur any moment, days, months, but I think certainly within a few years. The decision is yours. Take it to heart. Those 7 years, if you survive those 7 years, will be terrible. May God open your eyes. Accept Jesus Christ as your Savior and Lord. Be a wise virgin. Turn into a wise virgin before it is too late. In a few seconds, you can be hit by a car and be killed. You can be dying of cancer. We have had all those warnings. Take it to heart before it is too late. In Jesus' name I bless you. Amen.